And then at that point, I lost all hope, and I thought that I wouldn't be able to get better again. And then after some time, the Salima Hospital admitted me. Every time when I go to the hospital, they'll give me antibiotics to help me with the injury, but it never got better. And I had to be like that for months. And then there was one day when a son of mine from Milongwe called me, and I explained to him what was going on with me. And I told him that no matter what I'm doing, even the hospital is failing to help me, and I'm really losing hope. And then after some time, they had realized that this issue was getting worse, and they wanted to come and take me. They came to take me in So from October to December, at Queen Elizabeth Hospital, I received treatment and I got operations within those 2 months, within those 3 months. And then after some time, even though we had, I received that operation on December, the issues continued to get worse. Even my relative who was a nurse had opened the cast and noticed that there was a very big problem. This was something that only God could intervene in. And then I asked them, how exactly will God intervene? And they said that they'll take me to a church, a living church where I could be prayed for. I received that message on the third. However, it was on the Saturday afternoon when I was watching World's Night Hour on the TV, in which they had shown a testimony of a woman who had sores on her back and she had been healed. It was from that testimony that I received the hope and the faith that I needed to come here.
Then you don't think I can't even tell you the example. kada kule magazi kama na mafinya kama mamboko kwa wachini kusemusoni de mtaka ndimenda na ndaona macho kimu kwa 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 macho ineso kusoni tonu ni kwa eso kula para kwa mena magazi.
So on the next Sunday, I went to the old Malanga church. And when I was there, I just said, you had seen on the telecast. I walked in, I sat down. And as I sat down, I felt immense pain. And I tried to flex my leg to see what I can do to heal myself, but I couldn't. Even fluids were coming out of my soul. To the point that I was feeling rather embarrassed or humiliated with my condition. And then it was the entire time I wasn't even paying attention too much because I was in such immense pain. It was only when the ladies, the intercessors who are usually in the prayer line came to me that I realized that my healing was about to come.
Adam, we're going to be able to make one way, and it's going to be a little bit of 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 a little
nenera mwen, ki la mwen tou, ene se, ki la mwen wang wapaz. Ene se yi do e, ma zya jaman kou wak, ou ye le ti, ou ye la mwen.
And cleaning me.
I need for that to be happening. I'm going to have a visit. 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 I'm going to have a visit.
I'm going to have a visit. I Asana yile jino shemwa kumbili nini nina mwela kumbu. Nga kare ya remune ya bisho mwato. Kumu mawyo stunda jata faba mwato. Asiwa wa aisha.
My word of advice is this. That as you come in, prepare yourself. And as you prepare yourself, have the faith that even if the bishop doesn't touch me, I will be healed in Jesus' name. Let's come back for Jesus.
Please
remember that as you are preparing yourself, please prepare yourself. The bishop is only here to finish the work of God. God is the one who began it. Just know that once you are here, right, while you are right there, you have already received your healing and deliverance in Jesus' name.
I don't know how that that's really is on you, but many of them are not in the door. Zona ni unajili tiba, mungata mjota sababu yukuli anaone ni kutimiza ni zona ni unani na jose swadano wa malongu ya. Kwa kufuna kwa kwa kwa? Imene mwampera mituli, adambo kwanda wa malo wako, haimene yu nishu kundi ya chao, shimena na wila kucho, mamba wa anani na jose swadano. Na nuso tukula leo, nishu kundi ya manja wa yesu mba.